black holes are the natural enemies of all the spacefaring races. With their bottomless capacity to consume all light and matter, just a few septillion years before all things in the universe have found their way into the cavernous maw of a black hole, crushed into the infinitely dense singularity. And if Star Trek has taught us anything, it's that mankind's imperative is to survive against all odds. So will we take this lying down? Heck no. Will we strike first and destroy the black holes before they destroy us? Heck yes. But how? How could you kill a black hole? This gets a little tricky. For a black hole, any matter entering the event horizon is added to the mass. Shoot bullets at a black hole, and you just make a slightly more massive, slightly more dangerous black hole. Detonate a nuclear bomb inside the event horizon, and you only make the black hole more massive. Fire your forward phasers at the black hole, and that'll still make it even more massive. Swap those bullets in for lasers, and black holes don't care. Within the event horizon, energy and matter are one, and the very same black holes can convert that energy into mass. So all your projectiles and energy weapons inevitably just make it more dangerous. Well, what if we crashed a star into it? Would that fill it up or burn it out? Nope, it would just gobble that star up and go on with its business. And if we smashed another black hole into it, would that tear it apart? The cause is also the cure? Not even maybe. Just as soon as two black holes get within each other's event horizons, they'll just merge into a more massive and more nastier, meaner black hole. Number one, it's time to bring out the big guns. Reverse the particle flow, flood the dilithium chamber with exotic particles and route it through the main deflector dish, and construct your own black hole out of antimatter. And then kamikaze this new antimatter black hole right into the black hole that you want to destroy. Would that do it? Will that solve our problem? As you probably know, when you crash matter into antimatter, you get an explosion of pure energy, and it's the most perfect energy weapon we can envision. Unsurprisingly, this brings its own set of complications. It's not entirely clear that you still have antimatter in your antimatter black hole. It's probably just been converted into a regular flavor black hole. And still, if you could crash an antimatter and regular matter black hole together, you'd get an incomprehensible explosion, converting that entire dense and gigantic mass into pure energy, as calculated by Einstein. And as soon as you did, all that energy would be immediately converted into more black hole. Nothing, not even light itself, can escape a black hole. And that includes all your magnificent explosion energy from your antimatter impact. You wouldn't even see it happen. You just end up with a black hole with twice the mass. And that might just be what it wants. As we learned in a previous episode, we can extract angular momentum from a black hole. By dropping material into the event horizon, we can remove energy and slow its rotation. And we can even bring it to a stop. So we can slow down its spin, but that will make it go away. So is that it? Are we out of options? Good news. We have one last strategy. And it's so crazy, it just might work. According to Stephen Hawking, black holes can actually evaporate over enormous periods of time. Virtual pairs of particles are constantly popping into existence all around us. Then they recombine, flash, and disappear from the universe. And when one of these particle pairs appears right on the edge of a black hole, one particle falls into the black hole, and the other is free to fly off into space. And here's the amazing thing. This might actually reduce the overall mass of the black hole. So over an incomprehensible period of time, even the most supermassive of black holes will have evaporated away into a harmless soup of particles. So it turns out, in order to defeat a black hole, all we have to do is ignore them, and they'll go away all on their own. So what do you think? Tell us your best idea for how to kill a black hole in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Never miss an episode by clicking subscribe right over here. Our Guide to Space series is made possible by the members of our Patreon community. We'd like to thank Helga Bjorkhag, Ryan Finley, Steve Heistand, and Bob Harkins. Thanks, guys. And the many others who contribute to our efforts to bring great space and astronomy content every month. If you'd like to see extra material, like behind-the-scenes content, full-length, raw interviews, you too can become a member of our community. Find out how by clicking here. All right. Thanks for watching. Never miss an episode by clicking subscribe. We'll be over there? Over there? I'm trying to think where I'll be. How have you got me set up? Black goals don't care.